They're going to smoke up in their backlines, away from the Radiant Observer wards. Who's going to present themselves? What a surprise. It's Troll Warlord. They'll break the smoke on Fenrir. Here's the ESP, the pop already. The E-Blade pop from Syla. They're trying to find that duel into the backlines once again. This time it's Magnus being attacked, but the False Promise will keep him alive. You do bring down Notel, but XSS will also die for that initiation. The buyback can come in from Undying, but you've already taken Mega Creeps. How much they get in return? Maybe not enough, because the RP from Seth hits the money. A quick skewer back. The Sunstrike will even connect. RTW will be able to get one more into the double kill, and this really is GG. Aster will call it. The game is done. And OG, a very slow start, but they knew their timing, and they nailed it.
Yeah. And you can see right there.
But it's not required. Lycan into the ulti form, going with the level 3 Necros, wants to kill over on Notel. This will be a dieback from him if they can find the kill, while Batrider up on the hillside. The lasso, he couldn't actually catch on to Topton to look for a better target. Seb will have to be in as they just hold him in position. Mushi finally doing some work. Two heroes down for OG. One of them will buy back into the game, even though the gem has dropped the Mushi. He's just locked down. He has no more life. Maybe he does with the lasso that creates some space. They need to kill him by LTW. The stomp from Fenrir. It's good timing, but the Spider Fist is still doing his work. Fenrir, the Splitter, is trying to actually protect himself as he backs up and stops Thompson from charging forward deeper into the Aster base. But there's your Boundless Strike. Summon XSS. This really is OG's base. It has Aster on the flag, but OG took the lead.
He's just going to go for Throne. I love it. They have Monkey King ult up as well. I'm sure that'll be dropped right on top of the Throne just to assert dominance. Like, I've said before that clinical performance, This is textbook. What do you teach a class on this?
Mushi's gonna try and wrap around the back. It's a double silence. He blinks forward. The supernova is down. They're just looking for the first kill. Mushi has to defensively yules right now, or else he'll die. He tried to wait out for the supernova, but he's already lost his teammates. He's lost the game. This is over. GG is the call, and OG will storm their way over Aster into the next round at VSL 1 Katowice.
He's already smoked over HFN. It's gonna be caught by KP. Gets the Abyssal Blade hit. Needs more bashes. HFN turns around, delivers a bash of his own. He's going to be saved by the False Promise out from Chaos. Look at that. The E-Blade going down as well. The Winter's Curse in the back line on Tavo is going to be able to stall a lot of this, but Mineski just can't seem to commit, and that's where Weeha comes in. Weeha with a line break. KP turns onto him as best he can. Another Winter's Curse laid out on Tavo again. They should get the E-Blade onto KP.
There's so much silence.
Can they get up? He's dead. There's HFN. He's gone. Pylon died. Still being chased by Tavo. They need to be able to catch Tavo. He managed to get the instair. He's going to be able to go down. Weeha is also fighting up against KP, who managed to get the bass with the magic damage.
Oh, just so
the golden brace couldn't save him. Weeha is super low. KP's trying to kill him as best as possible, but Weeha is so damn tanky. The satanic, the regen, he's staying alive and is delivering damage onto Mineski.
And Moon finally runs out of mana. 3100 pool, he runs out of mana. They have to reset here. Is Pi going to get caught out too? Instant buyback from all sides.
Batsu back in, ready to fight again, and if he can't kill KP, okay, Ajit is going to go for the back line, trying to catch Weeha. Ethereal Blade now to BKP, and immediately the life break on Ajit is going to be able to push away. There
nice
goes that Winter's Curse.
Curse
is going to be able to stall things, reset. Weeha keeps on moving forward, is going to be force-staffed and breaking the coil. Meanwhile, KP fighting HFN, actually managed to break him.
That's going to be the first life, though. Another Winter's Curse, this time on King RD, but the damage just isn't there, and he has the Aeon Disc as well. Life break is going to be able to push away some of these heroes. Weeha is at half health right now, but still always had the saving graces of the Oracle, and it's looking like it's going to be Megas. KP on the side. Moon, it's actually found Tavo. Tavo going to be saved just in time, and now Moon going to be bashed up. Unfortunately, the Cold Embrace will keep Moon alive. KP hoping to be able to grab somebody here, but maybe turned around on as the side comes out. Moon dropping an orb out will not jump into Chaos. Looks like they're going to allow Chaos to retreat.
Oh. Moon's gonna pop over, he's gonna be able to jump on a Weeha here. Nether Toxin goes out, tries to turn around the Wukong's command. Weeha can't get away from this one. He will fall. Tavo actually used the hookshot, ran into his own allies. He needs to be able to block this. He is going to be able to cogs down. Fiend's Grip onto Ajit. Unfortunately, BKB just means all this magic damage is going to waste. Ajit is plenty healthy. Now the Fiend's Grip's fade. Went to the back line, though. HFN tries to go for Pylon Dime, but again, there is going to be that fade. Moon straight into the Crystal Maiden. Wipes him out with a Boundless Strike, and now the Doom on HFN. He's very dead. Misery's going to be caught as well. Tavo trying to block the high ground, but caught by Rod of Atos. Moon jumping over the trees into Tavo. That's going to be four dead from Chaos, as I don't believe there's any way out for Tavo as he tries to just battery assault Plink his way out of here. But a split earth landing from Febby will ensure his doom. 14,000 net worth lead, and look where KP is. He's already hitting the tier 3. Weeha gets a little damage on the move, but doesn't have the visibility.
And he's got the Guardian Greaves, but his team just doesn't really have enough farm. This time around, they've done a very good job of punishing repeatedly. HFN, he's got a decent amount of net worth, but it gets entirely nullified by the fact that he just keeps getting doomed in these engagements. Not really able to do too much.
Even harder now that the Doom has a Blink Dagger.
As we see, Febby does get picked off potentially here as King RD making his way, but it seems like they're loath to just let him die by himself as the False Promise comes out.
Oh,
the hook
nice!
Shot over the
jump
top.
In! Tavo, what a hook shot! They're going to be able to hit the Kongs in. Pylai died, though, surrounded by so many units. He's not going to die to the clockwork here. Not yet with his BKB, surrounded by another BKB and KP. The two of them are just going to march forward. Nice boundless strike. It's going to be a hit to two in the back line. KP jumps in, grabs that Crystal Maiden. Weeha fighting underneath his Nether Toxin as best he can. HFN trying to jump away, but Moon always making sure he catches up to him. Oh, no. Okay. King RD tried to get out that freezing field, but KP wiped him out. HFN trying to stay away from that Doom as well. Weeha, they've left him for last, the tankiest of all the Chaos members. They'll make sure they'll take their time with him. HFN actually jumping back in. Does manage to get the Monkey King. Weeha still alive until first down by that Oracle, but
HFN's killing everyone.
Picks up three kills until Pylai die. Gets another core kill off of that. Kills award as well. And now the question is, can he actually get out of here? He doesn't have a TP, and Misery does have a Nightmare, so he's going to make sure that he sticks around long enough for HFN to make his way over with a Remnant. That's going to be four kills for HFN off of that team fight. Eventually.
Pylai died, just trying to make him work for it. Even going to Yule's him up in the air, but a pretty quick reactive buyback considering they did leave the range racks available still in this mid lane, but I think they care less about that as HFN trying to figure out a way that they can trap him.
Trying to lead with Boundless Strike, seeing if they can get the combo up to... Oh, they do manage to get the Boundless Strike into the ensnared. HFN doesn't have a way out. There's just too much damage. Weeha TP'd in. KP had a BKB, so now that magic damage is useless for Weeha. He's just trying to stand on top of his own Nether Toxin, but that's it. Chaos. Call it here, Mineski.
Especially with the Furion, they're just able to pick up every single bounty and just build more and more of a net worth lead.
Oh no, Pylai died. They saw him coming in, just immediately get a stun onto him. But at the same time with his stomp, as well as Moon, right here, we hop popping his BKB. What a great split that's going to be. That's going to be enough to finish off both King RD and bring Tavo low. Ajit's going to jump in, finish him off.
That's
and now the BKB
has
finished up onto this Razor. Yule Scepter going down, trying to get out, but Ajit, again, pouncing on him, finishing off these kills. King RD turns around the spike, Carapace, but he back for this, and now he's gonna die back as Ajit gets the double kill. More and more buybacks coming in from Chaos as they TP in. Ajit needs some extra help though. HFN with that Radiance damage is enough to force the PA to jump away, but they need actual kills for all of this. They've got the Ember Spirit. Can they get this PA? PA, BKB turning. HFN is gonna be able to get over this cliff area, but won't be able to get out because of the Glimmer Cape. They do have the dust. They spot him more. All they need is big time crit. The gold's gonna slow him down a little bit more. The upheaval as well. Just don't get crit, and he's going to be okay. The Warlock, not as lucky, though. Ajit immediately dies, and Tavo managed to find one kill on Misery. He's going to kill the other support, and Pylai die, unless Ajit can do something about it.
Really?
A little bit closer, the Lightning Burst does manage to kill him. KP drops a little low, but doesn't get that third kill. Tavo doing a great job cleaning up the back lines before he dies.
KP, he's gonna see King RD.
Oh, he's getting the Radiance into the Spike Carapace. The follow-up,
can
maybe
you burst
can they
it?
Blow him up? The gold's gonna be dropped. They need to get off that Primal Split. A Split Earth lands onto KP, locked him out with the Rod of Atos, and there it goes. It cost them everything. Golem, Spectre ult, every bit of abilities. Oh no, King RD, Moon.
The dagger over the top.
And now Misery's going to be found as well, thanks to the Blink Dagger on Moon. He can just keep on searching for these kills. Weeha running into Mineski here, feeling like he can actually take a fight. Immediately goes for the PA, starts sealing away some of his damage with the Yule Scepter going out. BKB jumps out, breaks that link, tries to go for the kill on Febby, couldn't quite get it. Now Febby, Weeha is actually going to be in trouble here with the Glimmer Cape. He's projected for a little bit of time, but Ajit spots him now with the dust going out. And all these sentries, they're going to be able to bring down the Razor. Tavo, he's next up on the menu as Ajit just keeps
Stomp throwing out the other staggers, and what a big crit, almost finishing off HFN. The Ember Spear doesn't jump back for him just yet, but he's got the Blink Dagger. He will be able to catch up the sleight of his chain. Gets him in the end.
They're paying Weeha too.
Mystery can get the Fatal Bonds into the up. Oh, there's going to be the rock, as well as a big plasma field out from Weeha. Good Fatal Bonds on top of that. The Primal Smith has already gone down in the side. Ajit, he's already blown up two cores. That's going to be a buyback immediately from Tavo. Ajit, his BKB is now down, but he's still laying out so much waste onto Chaos. HFN is dead. He does not have a buyback. That heart wasn't good enough to be able to win the fight, and Weeha's damage is just pitiful compared to the rest of Mineski, who don't have a problem with him whatsoever. Moon challenges the Warlock at just 200 HP, that's enough to get the kill. Tavo just running in, trying to deliver any kind of kill that they can. Oh, not even Moon. No, Moon does die eventually.
He's coming.
Bot is going to come in, start to get some of the end. They have the Hex too. He needs some help here. He's got the Rage back up. Ace has gone in with a wraparound. Time dilation onto Notel as he's trying to focus for the easier kills. Notel, Pocket with a Wisp down, but the Bash has come through. Ace, he's killed off the Keeper of the Light. Saxa still been kept alive. There's the Chrono from Ace onto the two on the side. The Cleave as well, cutting through them. Sanity's Eclipse drop down. They've lost to on OG. They've lost the Aegis on RTW. The Shackle's onto Seb. Seb will fall. They'll almost certainly be able to go and kill RTW a second time. He has got the Rage. He's looking for Fada, but Fada with the Astral will keep himself safe. RTW is trying to turn towards Saxa, but Saxa still has the mana to turn with the Shackles. OG get team wiped.
Oh.
11k ahead. Their builds have paid off, and it's just going to take some colossal misplays from NIP, really, it feels, at this stage to allow OG to get back in, or, of course, some of that OG TI magic to also kick in. Maybe there's something that OG can pull off, but it's going to be... It looks almost impossible.
Absolutely. I mean, into all the BKBs, it really does feel
that Hex comes out and drop the Serpent Wars as well. RTW does have the backup from the False Promise, but they've already lost Notail. Thompson trying to look towards Ace. Ace has been disarmed. He's not messing around, though. Ace drops the Chronosphere. They managed to catch out Thompson. Thompson is dead. The Hex out as well as the Shackles chain locking down RTW as once again OG just getting slaughtered by NIP. Four dead this time. Jarex will be the... at least Ace survived. But at the same time, OG, they know that that's not really a target they can jump on. Ace, he's going to go to the Time Warp 4 straight away onto Notail. He's just running down the Keeper of the Light. Notail gets beaten down in a couple of hits by Ace. He'll jump up towards the side. RTW getting hit down by 33. He's trying his best to run. The Rage will wear off. Fada turns with the Sanity's Eclipse. Buybacks are coming out from OG, but they can't do anything, and Ace, he's going to jump forward, he's still got a Chrono, won't find the opportunity to hit the two of them, so he'll hold on to it for now. Sax has got the Shackles onto Seb, 33 will come and help finish him off, Seb is dead. As they're still holding him for now, they're not quite tapping out yet, OG.
They still got a Chronosphere as well on NIP. Ace has been holding it this entire time.
He hasn't needed to use it that whole fight. As Shackles are there, Chronosphere's out, Ace jumps in with the BKB. That'll be a dead Oracle for 70 seconds. Godlike on the faces for it. That Wukong's command is down with the BKB out from Ace. Will allow him to stay alive. He's got another Time Walk available as he gets out. They did lose PPD. So OG were able to get a kill. Cost them 3-4 buybacks though, at all. As OG ready to strike again. They smoke up on the bottom. Thompson straight in. They've got the catch onto 33 with the chains. Ice Path to follow up. Will be slept for now. PPD trying to give us some sort of safety to get out of there. But Thompson just continues to commit with the Flame Guard damage. Burns him down. PPD will manage to get the Fierce Grip off. But RTW just heads straight towards the main with a BKB. Two dead on NIP. They'll look at the tier 3 tower. They're even diving far behind it. Thompson with a slide. Steps in with the RP. Onto two. Dragging them back as NIP getting utterly dismantled. GG is called.